The limiting factor on how long a nuclear submarine can stay submerged is the crew's stomach. A U.S. Navy nuclear submarine has technology that allows it to stay submerged for an incredible amount of time. It can make its own fresh water, it can even generate its own air, and the reactor that generates the power to sustain these systems can operate for years, but it can't grow food. So what do? This is the next video in the Smarter Everyday Deep Dive series into nuclear submarines, and we're about to get a rare behind-the-scenes look at how food is stored, prepared, and served on a U.S. fast attack nuclear submarine on the USS Toledo as it operates under the ice in the Arctic Ocean. Today we're going to talk to Chief Doug Chatlos, who's in charge of cooking all the meals, but first we're going to talk to Lieutenant Mike Mace. Mike, otherwise known as Chop, is the supply officer responsible for acquiring and storing all provisions on board.
What is it? All right, so this is my freezer. So
this is your freezer.
Yep. This is I'm accountable for all the food on the boat. So this is how we store the majority of our proteins on the ship here.
Dude, it is cold.
I guess it's a freezer. Of course it's cold, but
holy cow! Look at all this meat.
Is that like a whole side of beef back there? What is that?
Yep. So we got some corned beef back there. We've got some prime ribs back there. We've got a lot of chicken.
Yeah.
We got a lot of chicken pucks, which are essentially breaded chicken breasts. Chicken nuggets, chicken tenders, breakfast sausages. We got fish. We got mozzarella sticks that you can see here. We got jalapeno poppers. We got a ton of bacon.
So how much food can you put on a ship? Like, how long can this last? Well, is that it? Are you allowed to tell me?
I am required to maintain 30 days at all times, and I have to be able to load up to about 90 days of food on board.
Really?
Yep. So we'll we are capable of being underwater for quite a long while.
We get roughly $10.60 a day per person to feed three meals.
Your home port is in Connecticut, right?
It is, yes.
So are you always purchasing food there, or like if you hit a port in like the UK?
Yep, no. We order food based off of where in the world we're gonna be, right? So if we pull into a base in Spain, then I'm gonna be ordering food out of the Spain catalog. Which is not always the same, so that comes up with different challenges, right? I have to tweak my menu so that it can support the food that I'm able to get in whatever port we go to.
This crew loves Carolina Gold barbecue sauce. We can't get that back home, so before we, you know, leave an overseas port, we'll load up on Carolina Gold barbecue sauce because we'll make the crew happy. So we have to think ahead and, you know, base our menu based on what we can get from the catalogs we're ordering from.
How many ports do you have to hit before you kind of like understand what the crew is like?
It generally takes a few ports. I've been on board for a couple years now, so it's, you know, I have a good feeling of what the crew likes and doesn't like, so it's a little bit easier to do. So, you know, next time we pull into a foreign port, I'm gonna be looking at that catalog months in advance and, you know, making sure we get from there what we can't get from home.
So do they let you guys know when they don't like the food?
Oh yes. Oh yes. Real quick.
Dry stores.
Dry storage? What? Can I walk in?
Yeah, yes.
What's your name, sir?
I'm Tyler, Sofian.
I'm Destin. Pleasure to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you.
I noticed you've got chocolate here. Am I seeing that right?
Cocoa powder.
How do you distribute the candy?
Me personally, I walk out and just kind of hand it out because I put it out. People just swarm on it.
What are those big, I don't know what you call them. Is that like molasses or something back there?
Oh, those are things of syrup for breakfast.
Oh.
The crew loves syrup.
Do they?
Yeah. If their waffles aren't swimming in it, they aren't happy. So
really?
We make sure we have plenty of syrup. Beef bases, chicken base, stuff that we use all the time. We got powdered sugar, we got cake mixes, the yeast to make the bread.
Can you show me the yeast?
Yeah. We have, I want to say, about 65 yeast on this shelf alone. That's 40 pounds of sugar.
That's just a block of it.
There's four individual bags in this one. Then we have like the fryer oils, tea.
You guys have been underway for quite a while now. So that's why it's so low at the moment?
That, and we load out for how many days of food that we need for the underway. We like to have a couple extra days just to make sure in case we get extended or anything. But I've had this storeroom up to the overhead and all the way to the door.
Really?
Full of food, yes.
Yeah.
And it's awful because when you have to get back all around the back side of the storeroom, you have to crawl over everything or pull everything out, get back there to get it.
So it'll take you hours back here.
Hours.
Thank you very much, man.
No problem, sir.
That's awesome.
Generally on submarines, almost everything we do is going to be from scratch. So, you know, pieces from scratch, When we do Burger Day, we do the burgers from scratch, we do the buns from scratch, we do the cookies from scratch, everything.
You do the buns from scratch?
Right, so
we love making bread.
Yeah, the grilled chicken sandwiches you had earlier, you know, those buns were from scratch too. So we tried to do as much
it was really good too. Can. I was expecting, when you said pizza night,
right?
I was expecting frozen pizzas.
Oh, no. So
why? Why are they not frozen pizzas? Why are you guys making it from scratch?
Quality's a whole lot better. Then stowage-based, too. Honestly, it's a lot easier to stow flour, yeast.
What happens if you burn a pizza one night? Does it happen?
Not generally with pizza, but there's been a few times where we've over...
Does it happen?
It happens sometimes. There's a lot of pizzas we got to make. It's hard to manage all of them at once.
Well, can we go throw some pizzas in?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, do it.
Absolutely.
I'll follow you.
This is the galley.
Uh-huh.
So we're given everything we need to be able to prepare meals for the crew. We have 180 people on board. Or, I'm sorry, 140 people on board. We'll be up to about 180. We have an oven right here. We have a grill top. You know, we use this for every breakfast. Do eggs, stuff like that. When we have chicken, you know, we'll grill chicken on the grill top right there. We have a deep fat fryer, which is actually really nice to have because submarines are the only ships in the Navy with a deep fat fryer still. So the crew loves it. It's definitely good for morale, especially with pizza nights. We can do cheese sticks, poppers, chicken wings, all that kind of stuff that the crew likes to get.
Legit.
Yeah.
What's your hat say?
The Blade Cafe is the name of the galley on board the Toledo here.
Nice.
Yeah. We've got a food mixer right here, so anytime we need to make bread or desserts, frosting, stuff like that, we have this here for it. And then we have two kettles right here, so.
What do they do?
Soups, sauces, gravies, you know, some of the entrees we'll make inside the kettles, depending on what it is.
So what's going on here?
Right here we have pizza crust going. It's proofing up right now, so. Normally we go through about 14 to 16 pizza crusts a night on pizza night, so. We have a lot of pizzas made up, ready to go. We have a few on standby here. That way, whenever some of these sheet pans start to clear out, we can make up some more. I think one of the most challenging parts of cooking on a submarine is just the space, because as you see in here, we have every countertop taken up with ingredients and pizzas.
I'm seeing how much room you don't have to work. They got hot grease behind me. So how many people will normally be in the kitchen here?
Just one.
Just one? So this is crowded.
Yeah. Pizza night usually gets crowded though.
I see all the stuff you got going on here, but I don't see where you wash the pans. Oh, is that what this is?
Yes, sir.
So you wash the dishes and everything all in this one room?
Yeah.
That's legit.
Yes, sir.
Is it hard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not easy. A buffalo chicken pizza just finished right there. And we have a half pepperoni, half meat lover. So he's got a few made up right here, so we can throw some in here.
Nice.
This is getting ready to go to Chief Quarters. Chief Quarters normally does like their own little pizza night in the quarters. And this is gonna go out on cruise mess.
So Chief Quarters, are they pretty high maintenance?
The officers are the ones that are normally the high maintenance.
The officers are?
Yes, sir.
Are we allowed to say that?
Well, I just did.
Hop in! This is the like Pizza that. Cam 3000.
I'm following you then.
Yeah.
Oh, hot pan.
Hot pan, you kind of have priority, don't you?
I have the hot pan. Go center your pizza?
There we go.
Nice. So is this a big deal? Is this a good night?
definitely good night. Whenever we have pizza in here, usually we have the lights dim a little bit, and we're playing some Madden or playing some cribbage. So it's nice to be able to just relax, enjoy some pizza.
Sweet.
While gaming out.
Rock and roll. Everything we did here. You don't look excited about it.
Just because there's no poppers out here yet.
Yeah, you can't make everyone happy.
So you get a.
Well, a lot of times we'll get this pizza from scratch and they'll still find something to grab about.
That's just the way it goes, huh? They're just ribbing you a little bit?
Yep.
What's the deal with the poppers? What is he talking about?
Pizza night, we usually do wings, cheese sticks, and jalapeno poppers. So he's apparently waiting for poppers.
Hey, your pizza's back there.
Way before it.
Yeah, you got one?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get some drinks and stuff. I'll bring the poppers.
Hey, pizza's back there. Is the cribbage about to happen?
It is.
I'll come in a minute.
So, we just gotta call down from Chief of the Watch to let us know that we're gonna be doing 10 to 15 degree angles. So, this is where it gets really fun as a cook. Because we have crusts out, we have pizzas coming in and out, we got a sheet pan full of pizzas, and now we're about to take some angles too, so.
Meaning the boat's going to roll?
Up and down.
Okay.
So, 15 degree angle is a pretty good angle, so if we took it right now, a lot of those pans right there may come off the counter. If we took it down angle, this hot tea would spill, so it's one of the most challenging parts about cooking on a submarine is being able to manage everything you have to do, and then you throw on the angles on top of that too. And
sir, are they just messing with you in the control room?
No, that'd be pretty messed up.
We have a cycle menu so that we can maximize our sustainability. So we have 4 weeks or 28 days for the submarine where we have set meals that rotate through. So every month, on week one, you're going to eat the same meals. Week two, you're going to eat the same meals. That gets populated by the leading chief cook.
Oh, my bad. So one of the interesting things about being on a sub is there's no day and night. There's no windows, right? So this meal that happens every 8 hours on this 28-day cyclical calendar is important to mark the passage of time. Even me, I was only on the sub for 24 hours, and when I got off, because I was so mixed up because of all my time zones, I marked the passage of time by when pizza was. Seriously, I was like, oh, that happened 2 days after pizza, or oh, that happened the day before pizza. It was the weirdest thing. It was like I was indexing my whole life around pizza, which, I mean, maybe I just really like pizza. I think having regularly scheduled, high quality, satisfying meals is a critical psychological component. We had ice cream on waffles one day, and that was amazing. They do that every Saturday or every Sunday. I forget what day it was. It was ice cream on waffles day. That's all I know. If you have good food, it makes you happy, and that's critical for success when it comes to being underwater for long periods of time.
So now what are you doing?
I'm gonna get some mozzarella sticks and the poppers ready for them. Gotta keep the Chiefs happy, man. The Chiefs aren't happy, no one else is happy. Mozzarella sticks, you overcook them, the cheese comes out of them, and then they're just not very good at all. So you really gotta watch the mozzarella sticks.
So I know that you didn't start a timer.
I know.
You just know?
Yeah. Once you're here for a long time, you just start kind of know how long you gotta put things in.
Literal silverware.
Are you still a popper?
Quest enter poppers and
mozzie
sticks?
Oh yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Sweet.
Right there. Need anything else? CSC has the cups.
We're all set.
He shows up.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Welcome. All right, man. What's up? You happy now?
I'm happy. Yeah.
There's a little bit of a smirk now.
Yeah, you gotta have fried food. You'd be good to go.
Rock and roll.
Okay, now that the crew chiefs are fed, we're gonna go to the pizza party in the back, in the crew mess, which is amazing, but we have an order of business before we do that. I told you in a previous episode here on the Deep Dive that there is required listening for the Smarter Everyday Deep Dive series, and that is Thunder Below by Eugene Flucky. Now, Audible sponsors Smarter Every Day, and you can get this audiobook for free by going to audible.com/smarter or texting the word smarter to 500-500. But here's the deal. I pulled the data, and I have a list of names of people that did not download Thunder Below for free. It was free. Why didn't you do it? Okay, so Jacob, you need to do this. Emily, we talked about this. We had a conversation about you getting Thunder Below by Eugene B. Flucky. Michael, Josh, you're on a submarine. Why didn't you do this? Anyway, I'm joking. Samantha and Jessica, I just want to throw your names out there. But here's the deal. I just wanted to tell you this because I did this gag one time before on Smarter Every Day, and I told people they had to get Skunk Works. And I actually met a guy named Andrew at an electronics store, and Andrew apologized to me for not getting Skunk Works. I was like, dude, it was a joke. He was like, I know, but I was watching it, and my mom was there, and you said I didn't read it, and she looked at me, and I just laughed so dang hard. So, in all seriousness, the point of this little gag, there's no data, I just made all these names up. The point of this is to demonstrate that this is a real person recommendation to a real person, to you. Like, I genuinely think you are going to enjoy Thunder Below by Admiral Eugene E. Flucky. If you just watched a video about making pizza on a submarine, you will be fascinated to find out what they did with the cakes after engagements in a submarine in World War II. It's amazing. So please consider going to do that. If you go to audible.com/smarter or text the word smarter to 500-500, a little link will pop up on your phone. You just click it. They've changed what an Audible subscription looks like. You now not only get a book every single month, you also get access to a huge Plus catalog, which has all kinds of stuff that'll just feed your mind and just make you genuinely a smarter person. So I love Audible. You will too. audible.com/smarter. And Andrew, you are absolved of not listening to Skunkworks because I trust that you are going to get Thunder Below. Anyway, just a little fun there. Let's go back to the Toledo and go to a pizza party.
Yeah, Saturday night's the movie night. Everyone watches movies while we eat. It's
okay.
Today to relax a little bit.
So this is movie night. So this is where all the enlisted guys eat?
Yeah.
Yeah? And so how often do you do this?
Once a week.
On Saturdays?
Every Saturday, looking
at. So it's like a morale boost, everybody gets together?
Yes, for sure.
That's awesome, man. So they're watching Down Periscope, which is a comedy about submariners, apparently. So are they exaggerating on the movie here?
Yeah, you don't take an angle that big.
Yeah.
And the way everybody fell?
There's no way.
Usually when we take a roll, you'll start to feel it, and everybody's body naturally adjusts. In this one, they made it sound like they went from here straight to like a 30 or a 45.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen like that.
Sweet. Rock and roll. Thank you very much.
Yes, sir.
All right. That's how to cook food on a submarine. Well, specifically on pizza night, poppers, and mozzarella sticks. I'm Destin, getting smarter every day. Have a good one. Bye.